Are you cool with how you deal with your litter box and how you clean your cats number one and number two? Whenever I ask someone what's your favorite thing about sharing your life with a cat, I never know what the answer is. But 99.9% of the times that I ask someone what's the thing that you like the least about sharing your life with a cat, every single time the answer is dealing with the litter box. So today, I would like to share with you what's my litter box formula to make this experience as good as it can be. From choosing the best litter box and litter, placing the litter box and cleaning after our cat, as well as some tips and tricks to make the whole experience a little better. This video is sponsored by Tuft & Paw, a modern cat furniture company that, believe it or not, makes beautiful cat litter boxes. You can find the link in the description box down below. Every relationship is a compromise, and the litter box is a compromise that we've made with our cat. We deal with their poop and clean the litter box, and in exchange, they're going to choose the litter box instead of elsewhere to do their needs. Cats like doing their things in dirt and litter, so litter training a cat should not be difficult. The struggle starts when we push too far this compromise in an attempt to make our lives easier when dealing with this necessary evil. Because oftentimes, the more convenient it is for us, the more unnatural it is for them. And failing to balance this compromise might affect their well-being and the bond with our cat. Today, I'm going to share with you some tips to make this compromise as balanced as possible. In the case that you're facing litter box problems, meaning that your cat is either peeing or pooping outside the litter box, one of these three things is creating it: territoriality, anxiety, or illness. Therefore, my number one recommendation is go to the vet. Marking, urinating, and defecating outside the litter box are amongst the top reasons for surrendering cats and rehoming them. So trust me, I understand how frustrating can this be to you. There are some questions that if you are able to answer are going to help your veterinarian diagnose what's going on. Has something changed in your home? Is there a new cat in the neighborhood or inside your home? Have you changed the brand of your litter or changed the placement of your litter box? Have you changed your cat's food? Where exactly the accidents are happening within the house? If you want to find exactly the spots where your cat is urinating, you can always use a black light. And as always, you will find timestamps in the description box down below so you can skip to a particular part of the video that you are looking for. By the way, if you're finding this video interesting, give it a thumbs up. It really helps us reach more people by telling them that this video is worth watching. The first thing I want to talk about is litter box placement, because cats use the litter box as a kitty Facebook. Mia was here, Mia was there, Mia likes this, Mia thinks this is safe. If we stuff the litter box in the garage or in the tiniest bathroom that we have on our house, we're limiting the ability they have to mark their territory, and it might become a source of frustration and accidents. The general rule to help cats mark their territory with pee and poo is to have one litter box more than cats we have in our household. So if we have one cat, we need 2 litter boxes, 2 cats, 3 litter boxes, 10 cats, 11 litter boxes, you name it. And when you look about the reasons that are having people not place the litter box in the living room or in an important area of the house, there are 2 that come to the top: looks and smell. I'm pretty sure that you've heard about catification before. We've talked about it in this channel. Catification, it's the art of making small adjustments to your home so that it fits both your needs and your cats. In the case that you haven't seen the video about catifying your home and enriching your cat life indoors, I'd recommend you to watch this video either by clicking at the link, or I'm also going to add the link in the description box down below. Why am I saying this? Because before I had a cat, I could not understand why people would have their homes filled with cat toys and ugly furniture. Then I got Mia, and I found myself surrounded by cat toys and ugly furniture. When I came across Tuft & Paw, I realized that they were into something. They create beautiful furniture that I am proud to show, and Mia loves to climb on. And I just got myself their most popular litter box to upgrade mine. It comes with a screen to make it more discreet, a scoop, and a cleaning kit. So having that litter box corner immaculate becomes a lot easier. You can find the litter box link in the description box down below. Regarding the odor control, there are some solutions that are amazing and some solutions that are not as good and might even affect our cat's well-being. Which takes me to the second point. Finding the right litter is almost as important as finding the right food for our cats. Also, litter is that one thing that both our cats and ourselves are going to deal with, so it's good to get it right. On average, a cat household spends $250 per cat per year in cat litter. But the difference between an amazing litter and an awful litter It's about $50 per year. I use World's Best Litter, and this video is not sponsored by them, but I would never recommend you a product that I haven't tried and I literally love. So it doesn't really matter if it's a sponsor or not. This litter clumps super well, has an outstanding odor control, and because it's made of corn, it's biodegradable and flushable. Cat's sense of smell, it's 14 times better than humans. And because they have such a cute sense of smell, using scented litter might be annoying to them. My personal preference is not using scented litters, but I could not find any study defending that theory. And because I could not prove it or disprove it, it's just my personal opinion, I don't like it, I don't use it. And for the same reason that I don't use scented litter, I try to keep the litter box extremely clean. Because if it bothers us, imagine how much it bothers them. The best is to scoop early and often to keep the house smelling clean and leave the litter box ready so they can use it again. There's this one thing that I love, that it's called the litter cafeteria test. You get every single litter that you find interesting, you buy the smallest package you can find, and you offer your cat all of them. In a litter box cafeteria test, you set several litter boxes, one next to the other, with two fingers of litter of the brands that you found more interesting. You clean every single litter box twice a day and you leave them there for a week. For this test to work, there can only be one variable, the litter. Everything else has to remain constant. If you don't want to spend money in six different litter boxes, my recommendation is that you get disposable trays, the ones that you put inside the oven, and you do it in those. After 1 week, you are certainly going to know what litter your cat prefers the most. There are some big no-nos when it comes to litter boxes that push our convenience beyond our cat's comfort in ways that I don't think are acceptable. This is my personal opinion and might be affecting products that you are already using to your cat. If that's the case, please don't take it as a personal attack. I am very happy to get the conversation started in the comment section down below. My first big no-no are automatic litter boxes. They are extremely convenient, but they make it almost impossible to track how our cat's stool look like. And you can learn a lot from your cat's health by looking at their poop. Whether you just adopted a kitty or you have had a cat for years, you should be checking your cat's stool color and consistency every time you clean the litter box. And particularly if you have more than one cat, you cannot track it with self-cleaning litter boxes. My second big no-no are closed litter boxes. Cats like being secluded, but not cornered. And this is particularly important when there are other animals or people in the house. If your cat feels ambushed when leaving the litter box, it can create trauma and it can cause them to avoid that litter box altogether in the future. Open litter boxes or boxes with multiple exits are best. If you want to enrich your cat life and elevate the bond with your cat, make sure you subscribe to this channel. We publish new videos every week with clicker training, adventure cat training, and general cat advice. Let's wrap it up. For a happy relationship with your cat's litter and litter box, there are six conditions that must be in place. Cats prefer clean litter boxes, so scoop early and often, and completely replace the litter at least every other week. Ensure an adequate number of litter boxes in your household. As we mentioned before, one litter box per cat plus one. Choose to place those litter boxes in places that your cat would naturally mark the limits of their territory. Find a litter box of adequate size, and if possible, with more than one exit or an open one. And go for a litter that satisfies both your needs and your cat's. Go for unscented, natural, and biodegradable. If you're going to change the litter that you're using or upgrade your litter box, do it gradually. Your cat is used to the current one, and being too drastic with the change might create accidents that you don't want. Get the new litter box and place it next to the old one. Also, if you're changing places of your litter box, do it 4 to 6 feet at a time instead of moving it directly from one room to another one, because your cat might not be able to find it. If you haven't watched the video about catifying your home, you can check it out here, but YouTube thinks that you should watch this one instead, so you can choose. Stay wild, stay safe, see you outdoors.